The Auditor General's report of the financial year 2021-2022 that ended on 30th June 2021 highlighted understaffing as one of the key queries at Uganda Institute of Information and Communications Technology, indicating a staffing gap of 59% out of 99 established positions. Only 41 positions were filled, which act members of the Public Accounts Committee.
To me, it gets to preparation. How government establishes an institute of this nature, and then it has 13 teaching staff. The rest you have to rely, I don't want to call them mercenaries because these are professional people, at least like they are mercenaries.
In their response, management led by the principal, Dr. Frederick Chitogo, noted that they're not generating enough capital to enable them fill the staffing gaps because they don't receive seed capital from the government. They also gave a defense that recruitment was halted by the Appointments Committee in 2016, pending the HR study.
The Appointments Committee reviews and submits a recommendation to
the Governing Council. When was the decision taken?
Chairperson, I'm requesting that we get the proper information.
You're right, because both of you were not there. I do not want to entertain another misinformation on my record. So, Secretary, you'll also need to cross-check because, one, you were not there.
The committee was asked by the staffing gaps at the institute and resolved by summoning the Minister of Education over the matter. Committee members questioned why government is not treating this institute as a priority, yet ICT is a backbone of the modern economy. Honorable Segona wondered why the government set up this strategic agency without seed capital.
Now, the last bit of the question is premature because we are analyzing and observing. But in this particular one, you can see that the institute is grossly understaffed and has been from the word go. It is actually malnourished. And over that, we want to interact with the ministry to tell us why they established this institute without providing for funds for it. The funding levels are very, very insufficient.
Minister of Education is the mother ministry that takes care of all these smaller institutions. One critical thing for me that I would need to find out if I'm to meet the ministry or the minister, they came out with a good policy, a good plan to have the institutions for information and communication technology to have a learning point. But this learning point, there's like a framework. You have given a framework, you have given guidelines, restrictions, you have given laws to be followed, but you're not funding.
Meanwhile, the Public Accounts Committee chaired by Wusiro East Legislator Medad Segona also grilled UICT officials on over-expenditure of 34 million shillings, money which was allegedly overspent on staff welfare, water, sewage, plus academic ceremonies.
Welfare. This was majorly due to provision of lunch over the financial year.
Did you plan for lunch?
Chair, we planned for lunch.
Yes.
But there are short courses that come up, short courses which are needed, and you bring in specialized staff to train those courses. And naturally, they spend the whole day there. We as human beings, like you have given us this wonderful breakfast, we also thought that we needed to give.
Let me tell you, this breakfast you're calling wonderful, and I agree with you. it could actually constitute somebody's lunch. This is the lunch we eat, and you make a lot of noise over it.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.